What's going on, YouTube fam? Sorry, my throat's killing me. Anyways, back in the laboratory with the Big Dogs Gotta Eat Fantasy Football channel. Today, we're getting into the third installment of free agency breakdown. We covered quarterbacks last episode. We did wide receivers the first episode. Now we're gonna land on the tight end position. Wasn't a strong year last year for tight ends, but there were some pretty big moves this offseason. We're gonna see if the position can bounce back. We had some big re-signings, we had some big trades. Today we're gonna go over each one. let you know their impact on the fantasy football landscape. I'm gonna be honest with you, this episode's gonna be tough to get through my throat, so let's just get right into it. Go do it. Music. All right, so first, let's head over to Foxborough, where the Pats obviously make another incredible move. What else do? They took Dwayne Allen from the Colts, basically. After losing Martellus Bennett, he wanted a fat contract. They said, nah, that's not how we play ball. We'll go grab someone else. They grabbed Dwayne Allen. Now, this is, I think Dwayne Allen fits almost identically in that offense to what Martellus Bennett was last year. And I say this because they're very similar players. Allen's a little smaller, but they're both complete tight ends. They're both very good pass catchers, and they're both very good blockers. A lot of people don't really know that about Dwayne Allen, and I got caught up in the Martellus Bennett hype last year. I was super high on him. Super high on him because, you know, the second tight end in the Patriots offense is usually very productive, and he had a good year, but it wasn't what we thought it was going to be, especially with the time that Gronk missed. Unfortunately, I think the reason that he didn't have that good of a year last year was because the Patriots used him so often to block because he was such a good blocker, and now that Dwayne Allen is here, I kind of see him doing the same thing. Bill Belichick said, I think he's one of the best blocking tight ends that we will see. That was about Dwayne Allen about 2 years ago. So I think it's almost a swap. I wanted to love him moving over to position because I didn't realize he was such a good blocker. But now that I know he is, they're probably going to be using him a lot as a pass blocker, which means he won't run as many routes. Even if Gronk gets injured, it'll kind of be the same setup as last year. So I see him more as a low tight end one, probably a higher end tight end two. So it's nothing I'm getting crazy about. And since we are kind of covering the Colts, let's talk about Jack Doyle. Doyle rules in Indianapolis this year. They got rid of Dwayne Allen and they re-signed Jack Doyle to, I think it was a 3-year, $19 million extension. And for me, I think Doyle's going to end up on almost every one of my sleeper lists or every one of my breakout lists, whatever you want to call it. I think he's a slam dunk tight end one for the 2017 season. I'm talking like top 8, maybe top 6, maybe top 5, maybe top 4, maybe top 3, maybe top 2. Nah, I'm kidding. He's probably like a top 6 or 7 play, in my opinion. And it's not strictly because he just has that number 1 spot this year, right? So you look at him last year, and he performed really well even with Dwayne Allen in the lineup. Doyle caught 59 balls for like 584 yards and scored 5 touchdowns and finished as tight end 12 in fantasy. So on his own right, he was a tight end 1, right, in 12-team leagues. When you look at the combined numbers of Jack Doyle and Dwayne Allen, so basically the tight end position in Indianapolis, they gave you 94 catches, 990 yards, and 11 touchdowns, which is easily tight end 1 last year. And I know a lot of people are going to get You're going to try to get cute here and be like, oh, what about Eric Swoop? Eric Swoop's going to break out or whatever. But the numbers I just mentioned, the combined numbers, were not Eric Swoop's numbers either added in there. Swoop also had 15 catches, 300 yards, and a touchdown. So combined, that tight end position for the Colts was huge. It's a huge part of Andrew Luck's production. So say, for argument's sake, say we take all the numbers of Jack Doyle and Allen last year, which were the 94 for 990 yards and 11 touchdowns, and we give 30% of that to Eric Swoop, right? That's a fair number. Give 30% of that production to Eric Swoop next year. Leave the rest for Doyle. Doyle will will wind up with 66 catches, around 700 yards, and almost 8 touchdowns. And that would make him tight end number 6 last year in fantasy football. So both of them are definitely capable of producing good numbers. Doyle, with that contract, 3 years, $19 million, tells you obviously he's their number one guy there. That production from Andrew Luck to tight ends has been absolutely nuts. 33% of his touchdowns over the last 3 years have gone to tight ends. That's a huge number. And as long as Luck's healthy, he's a no-brainer. 4,400 yards, 30, 35, even 40 touchdowns on a good year. So realistically, it's just addition by subtraction when it comes to Doyle. He's going to be the number one guy there. Andrew Luck loves throwing to the tight end, and Doyle's already proven that he can produce numbers efficiently in that offense. So he's slam dunk right there. He's someone I'll be waiting on in a huge number of leagues this year. Moving on to the Black Unicorn. Oh, Jesus Christ. Have mercy on me. Jared Cook had an offer on the table from Green Bay. Decided to walk. So Green Bay said, "All right, then, Martellus Bennett, strap up. You coming over. You're going to be a cheesehead." He said, "All right." On a macro view, when you look at the numbers, Bennett had a good year last year, obviously. 55 catches, 700 yards, 7 touchdowns. But it was a roller coaster season when you kind of look into the real details of how it went down. You know, he didn't produce in games where you thought he was going to, you know, with Gronk being out and things like that. And then he produced in games where you didn't expect it. It's the 3-touchdown game, things like that. You know, he's been constantly dealing with injuries over the last couple years. He's on the wrong side of 30. So there's definitely red flags there. He's scheduled to undergo off-season ankle surgery, something else to monitor. I'm sure he'll be fine by OTAs, but, you know, it's just a compiling list of these injuries here for Bennett. Don't get me wrong, Bennett's a good pass catcher. He's a good blocker. He's all around a good player, and I think he'll play well in that offense. But I think what's probably more concerning is just the lack of production that comes from the tight end in terms of fantasy in the Packers offense, like historically, with Aaron Rodgers under center. So tight ends have accounted for 26% of Aaron Rodgers' fantasy points since he's been in the league, which isn't good for reference. So basically what I did, I did a little digging. I went back to Rodgers' rookie year, which was 2005, and I'm going to list off the tight end fantasy finishes every year starting in 2005. I have it written down here, so bear with me. So in 2005, the best tight end on the Packers finished as the 24th tight end, then 34th, 10th, 21st, 12th, 39th, 10th, 13th, 35th, 26th, 11th, and 35th. So there hasn't been a single season where a Green Bay Packers tight end has finished inside the top 10. So 9 or better in single digits. And that's the entire career of Aaron Rodgers, which is ridiculous when you think about it, because he's always a number 1 or 2 fantasy quarterback. You know, it's hard to, it's like one of those like chicken or the eggs kind of thing. Has he just not had a good tight end in the system, or vice versa? But I mean, when you look back historically, just like, it's hard to, you know, the numbers don't lie there. I do think Bennett is just as good, if not better fit than any of the tight ends that Rodgers has had to work with. But I'm not setting my expectations too high on Bennett because of these red flags, just because of his injury, the lack of production from the tight end position. I think he realistically finishes somewhere between like the 10 and 14 range, and I think he's probably going to be drafted in like the 6 to 8 range. So we'll talk about Jared Cook. Passed up on a big deal from Green Bay. I don't know why. Maybe Aaron Rodgers was bullying him, taking his lunch money and shit. I don't know. Decided to move over to the Raiders, signed a 2-year, $12 million deal. And I actually think he's going to have a nice little pass-catching role there. Not tight end one or anything like that, but he'll definitely be usable if you're streaming tight end. Cooks, he's like a super athletic tight end. He's just never really had that breakout year that a lot of people expect him and a lot of people hype him up during the preseason for him to have it every year. And I'm not going to go out and say I think he's going to have it, because a lot of the targets in Oakland go to Cooper. A lot of the targets go to Crabtree. And they're scattered. Seth Roberts, Andre Holmes, I don't even think they're even in Oakland still, but you get the point. They use their depth of wide receivers very often. Now, Cook has had 3 separate seasons where he's had at least 600 receiving yards. Now, he's going over to this Oakland offense who has Derek Carr slinging the ball, and he's quickly emerging as one of the top quarterbacks in the league. Another big point that you should take away here is the Raiders' offensive line is one of the, if not the best offensive line in the league. So I doubt they're going to be asking him to stay in and block a lot. They're going to be using him a lot as a pass catcher. And the way he finished last year in Green Bay is definitely encouraging. So over the last six games that the Packers had in 2016, which includes the playoffs, Cook averaged 5.2 catches on like 9 targets and 70 receiving yards over those final six games. You know, it's stupid to predict based off small sample sizes, that especially ones that like players end the season on, because those are highly skewed. People love to go off like how the season ended, i.e. fucking Rashad Jennings the year prior to last year when he had that 4-game run with the Giants and then it was shit last year. Happens all the time. People end the seasons nicely and then people ride all over that. So I don't want to get too deep into it, but I think it's a good start for Jared Cook. And I think the Cook versus Martellus Bennett conversation that'll probably happen in the offseason is definitely a real conversation to happen for 2017. At the moment, I'd probably go with Martellus Bennett because I think his role there as tight end one is pretty locked up. Obviously, they're in a better offense, better quarterback, but it's not by much on any of those fronts. So I like Cook this year as someone who's going to get drafted super late. And lastly, there weren't too many other moves going on in this free agency with tight ends. But Lance Kendricks moved over to Green Bay. He was playing in St. Louis for the Rams. Wait, is it even... Who are the Rams are in L.A. now, right? Yeah, I don't even know. I don't even know what's going on with the NFL anymore. Like, what the fuck they're doing. So he was playing in St. Louis or Los Angeles, whatever. And now he's gone. So I think there's just one guy I want to talk about. A very, very, very deep sleeper. Goes by the name of Tyler Higbee. He's a former wide receiver, and he's super, super, super athletic. And the new coach of the Rams, this guy Sean McVay, he was the offensive coordinator in Washington. People within the league and people, fantasy analysts especially, love this guy Sean McVay and think he's like an incredible offensive mind. And he's the guy basically who was behind turning Jordan Reed into what Jordan Reed is today. I think Higbee is someone to definitely keep an eye on. Deeper leagues or deeper rounds. If you're in a sleeper league and you have 20, 22 rounds or something like that, I mean a keeper league, not a sleeper league. They have like 22 rounds. Tyler Higbee definitely is an option to keep in your mind because he's super athletic, and we've seen Sean McVay turn Jordan Reed into an elite tight end, and it wouldn't be far-fetched to see it happen again. So that's going to wrap up this episode. I apologize for the monotonous tone of my voice, but my throat is killing me right now, but I wanted to get this video out to you guys. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. That's how other people find my video. Leave a comment down below. I want to know, out of Jared Cook, leave two comments. You could put them in the same comment. Jared Cook, Dwayne Allen, Martellus Bennett. Who do you want most out of those three? And then the second one, I want to say Jack Doyle or Delanie Walker. Would you rather Jack Doyle or Delanie Walker for 2017? So answer those below because I'm actually interested in seeing other people's opinions. And if you're not following me on Twitter, my fantasy football account is at @BDGEatFantasy. So I'll link it on the screen right there. I just tweet out random stats throughout the offseason. Basically, anytime I do a new write-up or put a new video up, I tweet it out there. So you can follow me on that. You can message me on there if you want. Tweet at me if you have any questions or want to add anything to it. But otherwise, yeah, please share, subscribe, thumbs up. Do whatever you got to do to get big dogs on the map. Next up would probably be, I actually finished the write-up for the mock draft round 3. So if the running back landscape kind of pushes itself together within the next few days, that'll be my final and last fantasy free agency thing. But otherwise, we're going to get back into the mock draft round 3 because I already did 1 and 2, which I'll link here and in the description. So I hope y'all have a good rest of the day. Mwah! And
Brown liquor made my dog insane. Booted up with geek, it's the same thing. Fish killer Molly, it's the same name. Murdered by the stains, which can you claim? The big padded face cost 10 chains. Took your bitch out to eat on a private plane. Real talk one.